Good evening. I'm back. And welcome to Plus Dive for September of 2019, back on my channel. If you're new, I just basically play a little bit of the new PS Plus freebies, and I used this footage in this week's YouTube video for kind of more of a condensed view of the PS Plus freebies. But I am going to start out... Ooh, that is definitely a cold one. I'm going to start out by cracking open tonight's drinky treat. I've got Sioux City Sarsaparilla. Yeah, there you go. Yep, this is good stuff. It's basic. Basically, it tastes like root beer. If you're ever wondering what sarsaparilla tastes like, it tastes like root beer. With just a little bit of more hint of like maple flavor. Not quite as much as that maple root beer that I had one time. Whew. That was like someone took like a Canadian and crammed them into a 20-ounce bottle. It was overpoweringly maple syrupy. Okay, so I do it in alphabetical order. So I am going to start out with Batman Arkham Knight, because whether you say Batman or Arkham Knight, it still comes first ahead of Darksiders. So let's get started. Oh. And Teary has shown up. Hi, Teary. Hi there, kitty. She will be napping by my legs during this stream. I'm glad they didn't give each of those companies their own splash screen. Some do that, and it's just like, oh, come on, let me get to the game. And even so, we still have way too many splash screens going on. Oh, well. That was kind of cool. Now, the other Arkham games, they kind of had a little bit of additional motion go on the title screens. Oh, I can just barely see his face now. You know, the only downside to streaming is that I'm not using... I have to go through, you know, a bunch of different things, so I'm not getting HDR on my TV. And I'm guessing that this would probably be more impressive with the HDR turned on. Oh! Sound came out of the controller. I love it when games do that. Okay. Oh wait, let's see here. Oh, we've got another variety of Batman looking sad and off to the side. But at least this one... It looks like he's decided to call a friend and talk out his sadness, so we'll go with this one. Speakers. Adjusts audio dynamic range. Okay. I'm going to stick with TV for now, but I'm definitely turning on subtitles. Yeah, that'll be fine. Hints on difficulty. I'm going to go to easy and continue. I love it when they do that right in line with starting a new game rather than making me go all the way to a separate menu. Searching for additional content. No, I don't really care to do that. Oh, hey! Gotham's Greatest. Looks like I've got a couple of friends on the list. I have no idea what those point totals mean, but I guess maybe we'll find out. Let's hit the square button and see what happens here. No, doesn't really tell me much of anything. Oh, story percentage. MW percentage? I don't know. AR per, yeah, I don't know what all of this means. So, I'm not gonna bother, like, setting a rival or anything like that for now. Just gonna work on the game here. Now, part of the problem here is I haven't finished Arkham City, so... I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin.
criminals. And worse, not enough good people left to stop them.
That'd be cool. Oh, those birds didn't look like they were moving at first.
Hours for us to lose control of the city. Tonight, Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
Someday I'll get back to the idea I had for making a consoleized Game Gear. I think I can probably do it. I just have to actually sit down and work on it. Look at that mug. That is a view. Man. These are really good games, though. Like, it reinforces more of the detective angle and the fighting mechanics are actually pretty slick. Not gonna have enough glide to make it. Ah, okay.
You know, a part of me wishes he was still alive. Joker? Man, you always was crazy. Admit it, the scores he had us working were fun.
You do first person just for, like, binocular vision. It's mostly third. It's you play it in third person. Surprise. Okay.
Sorry, I've got to go. Stay safe, Barbara. You still know how to make an entrance.
But like the first game of the bunch,
last bus
even has stereoscopic 3D support.
I'm just glad my little girl got out when she did. Now the real work begins.
Any lead on Scarecrow?
We were tracking an unknown military vehicle speeding through Chinatown. It's the only lead we've had all night, but they gave us the slip. With the evacuation, I just don't have the manpower left in the city.
If you find it, tell your men not to engage. I'll deal with it.
Do you really think Scarecrow's crazy enough to detonate a chemical weapon in Gotham?
I won't let that
happen. That's his whole thing?
In case you need to reach me, it's going to be a long night.
Is that night spelled with a K? Haha, 47.
Hey, Batman.
I hate it when he does that.
Oracle, I need the location of Unit 247.
Already working on it. How's my dad doing?
He's holding up.
Somehow, he always does. Okay, I'm sending through the squad car's location. Be careful. It's not looking good out there.
Okay.
Man, I can't believe how quick they got everyone out of the city. We should make this a regular thing.
Good to know I've got, like, a couple hundred meters worth of, zipline cable in my gun.
I hear the
some nutcase going around, nailing people to walls.
Okay, I think I'm in the right spot. Okay, there it is. Boom.
You're gonna die, freak.
Whoops. I don't mean to do that, but it probably pisses him off nicely. Couple months ago, I played Arkham City for one of my YouTube features. Oh! And made it through an entire fight only by countering. Always keep them guessing. Okay. No, 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 no. I wanted to go off up there. Sorry, dude. I didn't mean to look like I was going to leave you here.
You're safe.
Thanks, Batman. I thought they were going to...
Uh-oh. Jeez.
The city's overrun. We don't stand a chance.
How am I gonna get down from here?
To pick you up.
Oh, okay.
What are you doing?
Evening the odds.
What I always do. Press L1 to even the odds. Hell yeah.
Oracle, I need to track that military vehicle.
A squad car has picked up the pursuit. I'm relaying its location now.
Oh, hey, there's my first trophy. Check that out. Okay, I will accelerate in a moment. Just let me take care of something here. There we go. I need the footage for my video later. Alright. Oh, sorry guys.
This is Commissioner Gordon. I'm calling off the pursuit. It's too dangerous. Sir, we're right here. We can take these bastards. What the? They just fired an RPG at us! Who the hell are these guys?
Yeah, get out of the way. Ah, you dumbass. Sweet.
That takes care of the vehicle. I need to interrogate the driver and find out what he knows.
Stay back, freak!
Well, I was trying to interrogate, but it just kind of went like a... Wah!
Get away from me! Where's Scarecrow? Go to hell!
Where are they? Hey, no problem. Have a good night, Atari Vision. Thanks for dropping by.
I got nothing to say to you, Batman.
And, yeah, feel free to pick this up. I mean, it's free on PlayStation Plus if you've got a PS4.
She's working out of a penthouse in Chinatown. I swear that's all I know.
If you're lying, I'll break the other one.
The other one?
Oracle, check the chemical analysis I've just uploaded.
Sure. Is this what I think it is?
Oh, cool. I can move the camera around.
Scarecrow's new toxin. An uncontaminated sample.
You're not kidding. I'll prepare a full chemical breakdown on the back computer. What are you going to do?
I'm going to go take a bat dome.
Nearby. I'm going to pay him a visit.
Let's hope this is the break we've been waiting for.
This is the place. I should check the penthouse on the Whoops. Top floor.
I thought I had that right. Screw you, lady. Unless she's talking to them. She's talking to them. That's gotta be it.
Something tells me this wasn't part of the plan.
Hi.
Well, that's made things a little more interesting.
Sir, Batman, he's here.
Were you expecting to find me, Batman? I'm afraid I must disappoint you. Take a look at the chamber. I want you to know the fear that is coming.
Listen up, Bat Freak. We're walking out of here, nice and slow. You try anything stupid, I'll blow your brains out.
Yeah, holding a gun to someone's head isn't really the type of fear you go for, Scarecrow.
Nothing like a little natural immunity.
Oh, okay.
What are you doing here?
Why did Scarecrow lock you up?
No, hello.
Shits and giggles.
Tell me.
And what if I don't want to?
Then I burn every plant in Gotham.
Oh, you wouldn't.
It started with a meeting.
What meeting?
Everyone was there. Penguin, Two-Face, Riddler, even poor Harley. Scarecrow said he had a plan. That together we could take you out. And Gotham would be ours.
Over my dead body.
Well, yeah, that's kind of the idea.
That was the idea.
Yeah.
I told him that I wasn't interested in his pathetic human games. And when I came to, I was locked up in that room. It's such a shame that his vile toxin has no effect on me. Nature always wins.
That was kind of amusing.
Will he ever learn?
Right? And he's right there. Oh, okay. I thought he would be. Okay, there we go.
You're coming with me.
You only had to ask. What's wrong?
Hey, DOS nerd. Thanks for visiting.
Target, sir. He's cornered. Don't move.
Are you sure it's him?
Confirmed. It's Batman.
Sir, that tank they have backing them up is unmanned.
Good.
That's gonna be tough.
Oh, okay. What do we got? Okay. Hey there, DOS nerd. Well, you at least got the cat's attentions. You're screwed, guys. That was pretty awesome.
Batman, I've spotted six more unmanned tanks moving to Chinatown. They'll be there any second.
Oh, this is sweet. Well, where are they? Said that they'll be here any second. Oh. There we go. That'll do the trick. I like that it kind of calculates the trajectory of their shot. Makes it a little easier to dodge things that are behind you. But it still works out, like, logically, because there's a, you know, computer doing this for you. Whoops. There we go. And there. All right, now we're this way. Oh, no, there we go. Okay, so I'm having some difficulties here because this isn't really conforming to usual, like driving game controls. Oh, okay. There we go.
Master of understatement as ever.
Oops, I should take that off. Yeah, three. Arkham. Well, okay, three main ones. There's Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, and Arkham Knight. This is Arkham Knight. But then there was like Arkham Origins on the PSP. I think there might have been one other one on the Vita. I can't remember. One quick moment here. Turn off that timer. There we go. I'm not playing edutainment tonight. Tonight it's just pure brainless fun. Whatever. Oh, no, I should probably stay in.
Back up! He's gonna get us! Jeez, he's coming after us! Hold it!
What's this? Destroy? Oh, this is just a challenge marker. Okay. But am I supposed to do that? Is that, like, the thing that I need to do next? Run battle mode energy system diagnostics. Okay, yep, I guess so. Start challenge.
Simulation activated. Weapon energy system diagnostic test online. Stage 1. Destroy targets to charge up weapon energy and activate missile barrage.
Okay. That sounds like fun.
Diagnostic stage complete. Stage 2. Charge the missile barrage to level 2 to destroy up to 4 targets at once.
Okay, well, then I'll need to charge things up first. Level 1. Come on. There's level 2. Okay. That was cool.
Stage 3. Taking damage depletes weapon energy. Charge up missile barrage to level 2 and destroy 4 active targets to complete diagnostic test.
Okay. But I have to wait until there are 4 targets around. Okay, I think we're good now. There we go.
Simulation complete.
Oh, that was just a simulation? Oh well. Rome.
Batman, I'm seeing a transport deploying more tanks at Panassa Studios. I've warned GCPD to pull their men off the streets.
I'm heading there now.
Come in, all units. This is Commissioner Gordon. We have numerous hostile tanks deployed across the city.
Shouldn't I?
Whoops. I want everyone off the streets and back to GCPD. We're not equipped to deal with what's out there. Thank God there's someone who is.
Shouldn't I be taking Ivy back to prison? Who built all these tanks? It doesn't really seem to have, like, a specific villain's signature look. Like, they're not waddling, so I don't think that they're from the Penguin, and they're not rigidly two-toned, so not Two-Face. They're not bright green with question marks on them. They're not ice blue. There we go.
Jim, tell your men they can resume their patrols.
Thank God. That joke was bad, and you should feel bad.
I need the isolation chamber prepped at the GCPD lockup. I'm bringing in Ivy.
Okay, now I get to take her in. Well, no, wrong thing. Not going to put her in Arkham Asylum, huh? Kind of gave up on that place.
What the hell? Hold your fire! It's Batman!
What is that thing? Are you kidding me? I thought we were under attack.
Any progress with the fear toxin analysis?
It's gonna take a little while longer. Drop by the clock tower when you're ready, and I'll show you what I've got so far.
Who taught you to drive?
I was gonna say, have a good ride. Sarsaparilla.
Scarecrow's gonna break you, Batman.
Honestly. Why do you even bother with these meat sacks?
Civil unrest? There's a war on the streets. We don't have the manpower or the equipment.
Well, look who it is.
Ivy. Well, that's one less thing to worry about.
Is the isolation chamber ready?
Glad you're putting it to good use.
Oh, good. Another cell.
Well, you know who can keep you from being in cells? Wayne Tech.
You feel safer now that I'm all locked up?
Gotham will feel safer.
We no longer have
another trophy.
Nobody's coming to help us.
Honestly, that's probably a good place to switch over to the next game.
Your choices. You have my word that each and every one of you will be commended when this is over. But the work starts now. Priority one, we're here to save lives, and it starts with the lives of your fellow officers right here at this precinct. I want a minimum of 4 guys on the roof at all times and a 6-man element patrolling the perimeter. We keep this building locked down. The only people who get in or out are our guys and the Batman. Now, those punks out there think they own this city. And as things stand, they're right. We're outnumbered, outgunned, and understaffed. But if we work smart, we'll get through this and take back the city piece by piece. We have outlined...
Gotta listen to the rousing speech here.
Bristol, Kingston, Drescher, Otisburg, and Port Adams. We got a half dozen choppers patrolling the skies, but make no mistake, we are not in control. Until we know what we're dealing with out there, until we have a solid lead on Scarecrow, our priority is to dig in here and look out for our own. Any questions? Okay, I'm gonna run one more time so we're clear. Priority one.
Freeze ice.
It starts with the lives of your fellow officers right here at this precinct. I want a minimum of 4 guys on the roof at all times.
Oh, okay. So he's just gonna keep repeating the same... pep talk, huh?
Solution. You just don't seem to want to hear it.
Screw you.
Damn bureaucrats. We're on our own.
We can handle it, Jim. What's the latest?
We've got incidents cropping up all over the city. Cash, give us a rundown.
All right, let's see.
Excuse me, Kitty. I need to move you for a moment.
First up, we've lost contact with the fire crew from Station 17.
Their
last known coordinates, but they're not going to survive out there on their own for long. Then there's this. It's a strange one. Body turned up. We didn't have long to look before the evacuation, but the forensics boys seemed freaked out. Real nasty. Also, we've had several sightings of the Riddler creeping around the train yard. Knowing that guy, he's got to be up to no good.
You're no good. No, you're no good.
Look, I know you're busy, but anything you can do to help is going to save lives.
Don't worry, Jim. I have someone working a lead on Scarecrow. I'll see what I can do.
Good to hear. I've got a skeleton crew searching Gotham south and west. I'm gonna join him when I'm done here. We're gonna find that son of a bitch. Fernandez, it's Gordon. Give me an update.
His mom was a dog? Okay. Let's save the video. Always nice to figure something like that out.
Hey, after you finish searching the docks, I want you to link up with Michaels and work your way back along the East River.
Okay, so let's go ahead and close. I mean, this auto saves as I go along, so I'm not that worried about it. Got two trophies, it looks like. Even the odds and lock up your first supervillain. Well, that one was pretty easy. Okay, you know what? It always gets me when you've got stuff like this where only 94.1% of the people got to the point where they got this trophy. And it's barely into the game. I mean, how do you play a game for like 4 minutes, barely press a button, and decide, no. I'm not gonna bother. Oh well. Okay. On to Darksiders 3. I've played all the way through Darksiders. I played a little bit of Darksiders 2. I think that was actually another PS Plus freebie at one point. And I've enjoyed them. I've enjoyed the series so far. I'm always a big fan of good world building, and the fact that this is like modern day post-apocalyptic, because the apocalypse got summoned by accident, just kind of appeals to me. Oh, that's a little unfortunate. There's some weird, like, jaggies just on the title screen. Gotta get a little bit of video footage of the title screen here. Fortunately, we got two good title screens this time. Sometimes I have to really struggle to get good title screens. I pressed the Any button. Okay, so let's go into the options. Fine with vibration. Damage numbers, yeah, let's pop that up. Graphics, audio, subtitles are on by default, yay. Okay. Right? Jak and Daxter is another one of the very few games that I have played through to completion multiple times. I've gotten it to 101% twice, and I actually started playing it a third time. It's just, I mean, a lot of people will sing the praises of like Banjo-Kazooie and stuff like that for 3D platforming collectathons, but it's Jak and Daxter all the way for me. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the lowest difficulty level here. Interesting. I think I'm going to go with the default combat mode there, just to give it a good showing. You get all of the precursor orbs. Like the special ones. You have to get every single one of them, and that's considered 101%. Wow, nightmare mode. Save will be deleted on death. No thank you. I'm not that kind of hardcore.
Why did the creator construct a universe teeming with imperfection, misery, sin?
Because perfection is boring.
Among the scholars of both heaven and hell, this query is known as the riddle of sorrows. If sin is itself a part of the grand design, is not sin then, by definition, divine?
Ah, that rhymed.
A question for the soul.
He's a poet and he wasn't even aware of the fact.
Particularly restless bunch kept a robust relationship to the topic. The Nephilim. Spawn of angels and demons. Warriors, relentless, unstoppable, blood mad, until they were betrayed by four of their own. War, death, fury, and strife. The four horsemen of the apocalypse. Inconceivable power was bestowed upon the traitors by those sworn to maintain symmetry twixt order and chaos. The Charred Council. Bear witness as the Council holds court to end the Nephilim War in the name of balance. This is the new pact. War, bringer of worldwide fire. You are the Juggernaut of all pain. Death. Decay, you are empty life. Strife, endless spirit of timeless unrest. You are all that is unsettled in the hearts of that which lives and breathes. And finally, fury, terrible engine of rage. You are the machine that...
Are we to waste our time on ceremony, or are we to fight?
Yes, that's basically what we were about to say.
You are the most impatient of your kin. The least predictable, dancing on the edge of your own reality. Your brothers understand the undertaking set before them. But do you?
Still talking! Shall I have Death fetch us some tea, or can we get on with it?
Fury.
Ah, yes, tea. That would be pleasant. One lump or two.
I wonder, will you light the flame of creation anew? Or stomp out the embers for good?
Well, I don't know. I kind of like fire, so let's go with that.
Dreams more thrilling than reality.
Had I known the new pact would be so exciting, I would have let war separate my head from my neck then and there. Is it possible to die of boredom?
Horsey.
Rampage. Bored as I am, perhaps you're just lazy. If I didn't love you so much, I'd kill you just for something to do.
I love that line. I don't know why, but I love that line.
The call? Finally. Please, please, please tell me you're a planet of demons that needs slaying. Or two. War. What pathetic.
Hey, I haven't seen you in a couple of games.
Brother.
Watch your tongue.
I may be least favored of all the horsemen, but my tongue never found me chained to a rock like some dog.
Fury, approach us.
I take it there is a mess that needs tending to.
Though you jest, you speak true. War has broken his vows to this council.
Is that the eye from, like, the Thundercat's sword?
The apocalypse. Why would he...
We know not. Yet. As we speak, Earth falls beneath the spears of heaven and the hammers of hell.
So the horsemen are to ride.
No. While the Char Council seeks to understand how and why the traitor war has committed this abominable act, there is a matter that requires delicate attention.
Delicate doesn't really seem...
Should have called strife.
That doesn't really seem like her bag.
The Masons have been released, by whom we cannot say, but the Seven roam the Earth, free of our prison.
Now that's a clear enough task.
The balance between order and chaos is already in jeopardy. The Seven cannot be left unchecked. War is in chains. Death is missing. Strife attends to other matters.
We can't pull him away from his hentai.
I can handle those fools in my sleep. But when this task is complete, I demand that you grant me my rightful place leading the horsemen.
If you would trade obedience for a title, so be it. But never make a demand upon us, horsemen. You depart immediately.
Hey, horsey.
Greetings, oh. Miss Fury. I must admit, this is a fortuitous fate. A watcher? You doubt my allegiance? Please, be not cross. I am such an admirer. Scratch that. I'm a fan. You are the horseman. The only one that matters. Enough! I will allow you to accompany me. Just stay out of my way. I will be as unto a shadow. Steadfast. Silent. More silent!
Go! Seek out the place called Haven. Your quest for the Seven Deadly begins there.
Fury. Wait. I... Whatever has passed between us, search your heart. You cannot believe I am guilty of these crimes. Something is wrong with the universe. Be vigilant, Fury. Forces conspire against us. Heed my words.
Thing is, he's right. It's kind of interesting that it's gone three games and they still haven't figured this out. It's also kind of weird that they've got two, like, action-adventure games this month. Usually they mix up the genres a little bit better. They're two very good games, though, you know, so I don't mind, but kind of odd. Oh, Fury, you know how to make an entrance. Okay. Anything around that might be interesting? Hello, car. Okay. Pretty basic. She doesn't jump very high. Okay. Fallen enemies will release soul lurchers upon death. Blue lurchers act as currency. Green lurchers will replenish your Nephilim's respite. And yellow lurchers refill your wrath bar. L2 to focus fury on a single enemy. Oh, okay. So that's basically, yeah. Lock on. Already?
I hope it's not envy. That one's a terror.
I'm guessing I need to go up this way because there's a very convenient... Okay, while jumping, whip swing, yay. Hooray for fun traversal.
Haven. A haven for what, vermin?
Humans, mistress.
Adorable. Build a house of sticks during the end of the world. Where exactly do we go from here, Watcher?
Skeksis!
I know not but what the Council commands, mistress. The quest for the Seven begins here.
Envy.
Humans, haven, everything here, mine. Move on, horsemen, or ye be mine too.
I'm on a mission.
I'm on a mission.
Protecting humans. Humans think creation favors them. They are apes crawling through dirt.
Well, yes.
Quite the grudge you're carrying.
What they have, I will take. When they have nothing left, they will be my playthings until they break. You cannot stop me!
I'm loving the voice acting.
Oh, I don't want to. Humanity is tragically overrated. I am not here for them. I'm all yours.
No!
I also like the character design for Envy. Looks vaguely corvid, which makes sense. Okay. Okay. There we go. I was stuck for a moment. So now I gotta get up there again. That wasn't close enough.
Your command is exactly what I desire.
Yes, I know. Thank you. You don't have to tell me that anymore. Oh, that was cool. Siri's still napping in my lap, and she's dreaming, so she's twitching against my legs. Feels kind of silly. Alright, down another level. Okay, THQ, I'm playing this game. Can you give me a new time splitters next? Ow. There we go.
Pretty. Come and get it. Ah, that's mine!
Crunch.
I am still Emperor.
Supposed to catch envy.
I did.
Watch.
This talisman.
It's a vessel. Envy used it to hold energies from the rest of the Seven.
It will make a fitting prison for the others once their physical forms have been broken.
If I may, there is a... well, a sort of hum emanating from the talisman. That glow...
will indicate when one of the Seven is nearby. I know.
So wise. You are all that the Council promised, Mistress.
I'm beginning to enjoy the sound of your voice, Watcher.
Oh, that's Freda Wolf as the Watcher. Sweet. Talisman of Sin. Okay. What's this? Okay. Ah. That appears to be the way out.
Duties if I didn't point out that even with the talisman, locating the other deadly sins will prove a challenge.
Finding envy was easy enough.
That was a gift, one I would not count on receiving twice. Envy was also by far the weakest of the deadly sins.
Anything else to add?
Only what I assume you already know. The armies of both heaven and hell have cordoned off the world of man into various areas of influence. Look around us. The upheaval we have seen is the very personification of the struggle between order and chaos. You have set for yourself an unenviable task, given these environs.
That's what makes it fun. The other sins are hiding across this shattered world. They strike at angels and demons alike in their own selfish bids for power. Their hubris will lead me right to them.
Perhaps. But you will need assistance.
Whatever I need, I will take, Watcher.
Oh, hold on. There we go. Lost my audio for a moment. Whee! Oops. Okay, what is this? What is this? What is this? What is this? Oh, well.
I knew that war would one day unleash all this. But seeing it... his gifts are impressive.
May I remind you, Mistress, that you have no peer among your horsemen brethren.
Suck up. Dang. Thought I had that. Are we good now? All right. Not sure if I can get over there. But this is one of those Zelda-ish games where you're going to keep coming back and exploring places after you get new abilities, that sort of thing. Oh, okay. Just automatically crawl, I guess. Oi. That's no fair. I don't have any sort of ranged attack. I mean, beyond my whip. Okay. Looks like that's getting a little loud on the mix, too, so I'm gonna turn that down just a little bit. And then also turn it down on the TV. There we go. I know, I just don't really feel the need to quite yet. Still almost at like 40%. And none of these guys are doing that much damage. Ah, okay. This guy's getting annoying. Ah, use my dodge to close distance there. Okay, that was fun.
Perhaps there are human survivors.
Not my concern.
Very, very brief loading screen there.
That tree. It's impressive. But is it just me, or is it out of place here?
It is a maker tree. Most likely we will find refuge there.
All right. Yeah, jumping right down in front of a Horseman of the Apocalypse seems like a great idea. It's still a little too loud for me on my earpiece here. Alright. Ah. See, that blue thing looks special. Let's see if I can... Nope. I like her whip. It's pretty cool.
This is the demon who announces his ambush.
It was not my intention to do battle, horseman. Such a passionate little thing, aren't we?
Do not test my patience.
Very well. War is too hazardous an occupation for myself, horseman. I am here in the name of blind capitalism. I am Volgrim, merchant of the damned. A trader who deals in souls for profit. Even in the face of the apocalypse, one must endeavor to earn a living.
And whose souls do you trade in?
Angel, demon, or even human. All souls have value to me.
Souls.
I've seen the trail of bodies you've left in your wake.
Did they leave any souls?
That depends. What are your needs?
Information. The seven deadly sins.
Whispers on the wind say that the fabled horsemen are but pawns in a larger game. Victims of a grand setup.
What do you know?
I know that the first one's free. Call for me if you have souls to trade, and perhaps you will consider my wares valuable.
What you buying? Volgrim Plinth. Plinth is such a wonderful word. Okay. Oh, cool. Fast travel. Okay. Relics. Talisman of Sin. Already got that. Barbs of Scorn. Okay, well, let's bump up... Nope, I don't have any attribute points. Hey, Volgrim.
What would you ask of this humble merchant?
Feed souls!
This will be fun for both of us.
Woohoo! I'm holding down the triangle button! Fun! For both of us.
As you wish. Take your time.
Ah, now I can't use those to buy anything. Okay, good to know. Ah. That's cool that there's a respec item. And it doesn't seem to cost very much either. Considering I already had like 1100. Ooh. I like these specials. Those are probably going to be my targets. Because they'll be, like, permanent upgrades, it seems.
As you wish.
Yeah, I don't want to know about your serpent hole right now.
Farewell for now.
But I do want to increase my physical damage. Yay! The first of many. Okay, I'm gonna split the recording here. And continue. Wait, this is the way I came in. What is this? Looked cool.
Fulgrim and his demon tongue. They live to confound and feed of the scraps of a world they help destroy.
Indeed they do.
But despite his thirst for souls, Fulgrim may be a useful tool on this journey.
Yep. That looks like something I can whip at, so... But this also looks like something I can climb. Nope. Okay. So let's try this. Yep. My first thought was correct. Bye-bye. Alright, let's go this way first. Well, that seems pleasant. Oh. Okay, well, I guess I have to come back to that later.
The length these roots have grown. They seem to have taken over everything.
Indeed, mistress.
Did something pop up behind me? No? Okay. Seemed like it had. Ooh. Good thing I turned around, though. Might have missed this. A medium lurcher clump. They've got great names for stuff in this game. That's your lurcher clump right here. Yeah, I got your lurcher clump right here. See? Isn't she a cute little lurcher clump? Oh, complain, complain. Hello? Oh, off to the side. There we go. Alright, I probably need to go that way, but I'm gonna go this way first. Jeez, how was I missing them so badly? There we go. Well, this is a long beaten. Long sidetrack here. Also kind of looks like I can go off this to the right. And nope. Nope. Ooh, that was cool. Yeah, there was nothing to actually swing on. So, yep, this is something I need to come back to as well. Oh. You are correct. I forgot to change that. I'm always so bad at that. There we go. How's it going? Oh, I pressed the square button. That is a thing I'm supposed to be able to swing on, but it's not letting me. They're pretty good. And it's got a great kind of world-building story to it, too. Basically, war begins the apocalypse. You've got the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. In the first game, war starts the apocalypse, but he wasn't supposed to. He got a false signal. So he accidentally started the apocalypse. You're in kind of a modern-day Earth in these games. In Darksiders 3, you're playing as... In Darksiders 3, you're playing as the Horseman Fury. I think Darksiders...
I'm curious as to who remains here.
I can't remember, but I thought Darksiders was a recent PS Plus freebie. But if not, I probably got it from... They do THQ Humble Bundles fairly frequently for PS4 games. So you can keep an eye out for that and get the other two if you're interested. Oh, you have them. Okay. It's pretty good. I played all the way through the first one. I haven't played all the way through the second one.
Greetings. Take your time.
Okay, well, I could buy something, but I don't want to right now.
As you wish. This will be fun for both of us.
I'll just go up to the next level here.
As you wish.
And let's get more health. Okay. Moving along. A human? Three humans?
Behind me, we ones. Let me tend to our uninvited guest. A horseman.
Fury, currently reserving the right to kill you where you stand. And you are?
Surprised. And more than a little relieved. Call me Ulfane Blackhammer.
So, you'll not be flattening me today?
A maker, are you not?
Aye, when there's something to make. Today, my skills are only aimed towards instruments of death.
Hey, I'm interested in that. War.
No, not theirs neither. Like your council, I care for balance, horsemen. Humans, frail as they be, are part of the balance. Surely you're here to help protect them.
Wrong question.
A tribe of useless, hairless simians whose greatest talent was inventing ingenious new ways to divide and destroy one another.
She's not wrong.
They could suffer forever or die tomorrow, and I wouldn't bat an eye either way.
Then what is your business here?
What do they call you?
Jones.
Jones. Question me again with your last breath.
Hey there, insert joke.
Look around. Look what's happening.
Welcome, welcome.
Do you honestly think anything scares me now?
Easy, lad. This one's none for trifles.
Yeah? What do I have to lose? This moronic conflict makes you all look so stupid. Angel, demon, horseman, even maker. What are you even fighting for, huh? Tell me!
I like this one. You may continue breathing, Jones.
Horseman, please. To have you on our side would turn the tide in ways we cannot measure. Humanity might stand a chance.
While my mission does involve balance, it does not require them. I am here to root out the seven deadly sins and return them to the Council. No less, no more.
What if I can help you? That bit of chain you carry could use some work.
I sincerely doubt that. I'm faring quite well without any help.
Yeah.
Of course.
It basically completes my collection of the games.
I am a maker who specializes in instruments of destruction, chaos, and the deliverance of pain. So it stands to reason that wee little Ulthane could enhance your arsenal.
Wee little Ulthane.
If your horsemanship would give me the chance.
In exchange for?
Humanity will not survive without aid. If you come across any humans on your journey, please direct them here. Haven is the only place they might be sufficiently protected.
Do you use your head as a makeshift anvil?
How do you expect the apes to cross a battlefield and find you?
Oh, I don't. They'll need this. The bridge. Only humans can use it. One touch, they're sent to Haven.
Must I touch them? I accept your offer, Maker. Though I doubt it will make your collection any less useless.
We have a non-deal, then. As a show of good faith, a gift. Wrath.
Where?
You seek a pit of Hellstretch set in the Nether, beneath the city. And please...
Yeah, I've only played through the first one. I played a little bit of two.
Pointless as it may be.
We'll see. And remember, Fury. The doors of Haven stand open to any who ask.
Ah, the bridge stone. Who are you?
Welcome, horseman.
Oh, wow, cool. All you say is welcome, though.
Hey, horseman. You my horseman or horse lady? Horse person?
Yeah, I thought so, yes. Wasn't it, like, both remastered versions on the PS4 at one point? Alright, well, let's head out this way. I haven't done this yet, so...
He is certainly committed to his cause. Ulthane. He is blind to what truly matters. Perhaps, yes. Just another pawn who will never understand the game into which he's been played. And he does love the sound of his own voice, doesn't he? Not like any.
Oh, gotcha.
Did you say something?
See, before I got my PS4, I actually picked up all the freebies using the web-based store. So by the time I did get a PS4, I had some games for it. Same with the Vita. Want to negotiate? Okay. You're a creepy looking bastard, aren't you? Took a little bit more effort, too. Ah! Adamantine. Can I go under the bus? No. Okay. Okay. Like, do I have to run all the way around the other side of the boss? Large lurcher clump. Okay, that's where I came down, so let's head up this way. Let's head toward that tornado first. Ah! Ah, it's probably something I unlock later. It's been a long time since I've played through, Yep, this looks like a set of walls to jump on. And there's another one of those spiderweb walls. So this seems like it's supposed to be a hub area that I keep coming back to. Which makes sense, because I'm right outside of Haven. Okay, that's Haven. That's you. Fifth Avenue. Oh, I thought I'd been back here already. Well, let's grab that clump. Or, oh, it's a cluster. What was that? And there's stuff way up there that I can't get to yet. Oh, I might be able to get to there. Hold on. If they let me get up on top of this bus. There we go. Nope. Oh, you're large. But you're dead now. All right, what's all this crap? I'm guessing I can't break through this yet. But that I will be able to eventually. There's stuff back there. And I was making a pleasant crumbly sound. Lots of indications that I'm going to come back here again later with more abilities, but I can't really figure out where I'm supposed to go. Can I go through here? Nope. Okay, is there like any sort of map? No. All right, well, let's fast travel.
What do you ask of this beast?
Take your time.
Please take your time.
Okay, so I'm at crossroads right now, which makes a lot of sense. Skyscraper seems to be farther along, maybe? Okay, I need to shift you again so I can shift my legs. It's okay. Sleepy kitty. Yep, yep, yep. Oh, I remember this place. This was the first place I met Volgrim. So...
Greeting. Please take your time.
Okay, so there's a special icon there. I wonder if that means that I'm supposed to go that way. Maybe I left the forge in the wrong direction. I don't know. Yeah, okay. So let's go back into the forge. I don't get why she's gotta wear heels. It doesn't really seem conducive to running. I mean, you know, running on the balls of your foot, yes. But with large spikes on the heels, that seems like it would trip you up. Alright, let's go this way, see if this will take me somewhere special. I'm glad you're not out there either. Or two, or
this place whatever. Is beautiful.
It is kind of pretty. Whee! Well, still can't get through those. Let's see if I can go down this way. Nope! Okay, so this is how I came in, and that's where the forge is.
What would you ask of this? Please take your time.
Well, now the skyscraper is marked. I don't get it. Let's go back to the west end. Poke around here a little bit more and but it's kind of weird that I feel so lost already. I would like for there to at least be a map in the menu so I could, you know, look around and figure out where I'm supposed to go. Okay, I've been this way. Let me look over this way and see if there's something I missed over here. Well, there is. But not like a path. I don't think I went this way. But that's another one of those, like, wall-to-wall jumps that I can't do yet. Okay, so that would probably take me back to where I just came up from. Doesn't look like there's anything useful down there, so let's jump across like we did before. Through here. I mean, transversal is fun at least, but I feel like I'm just missing the one little thing that would have shown me the way that I'm supposed to go. I feel like I'm probably going to make my way... Oh! A little bit of a longer loading time this time. I feel like I'm probably going to find the, find Haven again really quick here. Yep. Nothing up there. Had to check. Gotta check everything when you're lost. Yep, now I'm right back to the, to Volgrim. So I could just fast travel, but... I want to explore a bit. Okay, how do I use those lurcher clumps? Is it in here? No. Wait. Ah. Okay. Shatter all. getting close to the 5,000 I need for a power up. Okay, now I've gone both of those directions. Continue forward. Oops. There, no. Ah, here we go. Ah, it's frustrating. There we go. Here, and this is the entrance to the forge. Okay, I've explored all of that.
Well met, horseman.
Talk to everyone. Okay, so this has to be the way I go. Gotta be just one little thing I'm missing. Welcome back. I'm gonna give you another hug because I'm watching a hidden loading screen. There we go. Do anything with these. Nope, that's not a place to crawl through. Doesn't do any good. Can't get up there. But I'm going to try again anyway. Is there any sort of grapple? Nope. No good there. Ooh. What's this? Nope. Oh, how did I miss that? Lurcher clump. Okay, there's that weird altar thing. Some breakable wall that I can't break yet. Nothing down there. Can I jump anywhere from here? No, it doesn't look like it. It's not bad, but I'm kind of stuck. I don't know where I'm supposed to go next. I'm finding a bunch of barriers that are kind of obviously there to be overcome later when I get new abilities. But I lack those abilities. Yeah, I have no idea where I'm supposed to go. Well, that's a shame. But I think I'm done for the night here. And normally I would go for another hour, but on my plus dive streams, I'm kind of on a tight clock. Because now I've got to condense this all down to highlights and put voice to it and get it out on YouTube by midnight tomorrow night. So, I'm gonna close this. I might come back to this at some point and just, you know, see what I was missing. It's probably something extremely obvious, and I'll probably smack my forehead when I see it. But I'd need to look it up. So let's take a look at my follow list. So programming notes. I will not be streaming again next week. I will be on vacation next week. The week following, I will be back. So that'll be the 15th and 16th of September. And I'll be picking back up with my, edutainment stuff. I've got chapter or discs 2 and 3 of the Quaddle Family Mysteries on their way. I found them on eBay really quick last night, so I'll be able to finish that up. And then because that's the third week of the month, that Tuesday I will be doing AntStream Antics. So I'll be playing games on the AntStream Retro Streaming Service. That I'll be playing some new challenges and some of the new games they've added to the service. So if you're interested in like arcade, British retro, and Commodore 64, which was kind of worldwide retro, then stay tuned for that on the 17th. But tonight, I think we're going to go raid Infamous GM1. The Super Bro Chacho himself. And what is he actually playing right now? Retro. he's playing some sort of Zelda game. Ocarina of Time. Okay, perfect. All right, so let's head over there. Thanks for dropping by, folks, and I'll catch you in 2 weeks.